made it. Had to wait for this other guy because I kind of came around, screwed up, swang wide to go around the building. Didn't need to. But, so I had to go all the way back around the two buildings and then come through. Dude took about 20 minutes to unload. He seems to be fast, so I only got 11 pallets, so hopefully he's fast. But, tricky little thing, but the backing wasn't too bad like I thought it'd be, but a bit muddy. I got mud all on my floor. I'm not happy. I need a freaking... I did have a, carpet, that's what I'm saying. So I got carpet here, but I don't want to get that, like, muddy and stuff. I want, like, an actual carpet that stays down in the well that I can just, like, you know, get dirty and all that. Instead, I got to freaking sweep it out. I got to clean it somehow. Or I might just leave it. I don't know. I'm lazy with it. But yeah, so dispatch sent me a load yesterday. And so I have to go 50 miles back the way I came to Nampa. And then pick up. Open appointment anytime today, pick up, and then start heading down to Phoenix for a drop on Monday at 5 a.m. I can make it there before then, no doubt. And I guess I'm glad I'm going home early. I'm gonna see if I can find one more load before I go home. Hopefully there's something in Phoenix that can go to Tucson. I know that it has to be something. It's only a 2-hour drive. We'll see. So it started snowing. I'm here getting loaded in Nampa, Idaho. I don't think they started yet. They came out, put the seal or the lock on my freaking brake line. But they haven't started. I'm like, okay, been here like 30 minutes. Whatever. But it's not sticking, so that's nice. But I would like to get out of here as soon as possible. I don't know. I'm going south, so I'm going to be heading east. And then south on the 93 down through Nevada and into Arizona. And I don't think it's going to be a rough ride. Oh, man. But we'll see. I just want to get out of here. Last time it started snowing while I was getting loaded, it snowed a lot. And then I was stuck in it for the rest of the day. But this is in Minnesota. But Idaho is not much better. So, we'll see. Hey guys. What's up? How's everybody doing? I hope everyone had a good weekend. I had a good weekend. I had a great freaking week. A good weekend. Took it nice and easy here. As I stated earlier, let's see. I came down from, so I had a run to Washington. Then a run to Idaho. And from Idaho back down to Arizona. And that's where I'm at right now. As you can tell by the boring ass trees behind me. Freaking, I'm in Phoenix. So I'm parked here at the shipper in Phoenix. I just woke up from a nap. Hella tired. My freaking contacts are hella crusty. And I just thought I decided to come out. I mean, it's what is that sunlight hour thing at 5:30? I don't even know anymore. So I just decided to come out, talk to you guys a little bit. I know I have not done a video in like 3 weeks. I've been lazy with it, I'm not gonna lie. I was like, oh shit, I could come out. To be fair, I was on vacation for like 2 weeks. And I brought my laptop with me and everything. And I was like, ew, maybe I can record. Didn't happen. So, that didn't happen. Don't mind me. Just eating pepperoni over here. I've been sitting in my lunchbox the entire day. But don't worry, it's insulated. It's not rotten. Although I am one to, you know, eat some questionable things. It's all good. So I got here. Everything was okay. I left. I made breakfast in the morning with my boss. We were hanging out. And we finally split. He went to Cali. I went down to Phoenix. The night was good last night. We ate at our usual sushi spot in Vegas. We always stop there. It's right by the TA on Blue Diamond Road. Right across that plaza, like two plazas over where the Target is, there's a sushi spot. I recommend any of you who go to Vegas, who gets a chance to stop in Vegas, definitely stop at that TA and walk a little bit over to Blue Diamond Road because they have the best sushi around. I swear by it, I swear. And if you're visiting Vegas, go to the same place. So, I get to Phoenix. It's nice out. It's like super nice right now. It was nice all day. It actually was pretty hot in the cab. I had to turn on my AC. And definitely different from up north. It was cold as heck. And I get here, it's like 50 some degrees, 60 some degrees. I was like, cool. Right now I'm wearing like my little slippers. I was bored. I took off my freaking boots to take a nap. And then I was just like, you know what? I'm not even going anywhere, so might as well. And now I'm just chilling. I don't have to deliver until 5 a.m. tomorrow morning, which is great. So I had the entire weekend going to go like 900 some miles. 990 miles, I think, is what I had for this load. And pretty good load. It was paying... Damn, what the hell is this little thing? Like 20 some hundred for this load, I believe. So it was pretty decent. I didn't mind. I hit like around either 8,000 or a little above 8,000 this week for, you know, the truck revenue. So I'm happy. You know, we didn't get paid this week because I took like 2 weeks off. So that's not fun. But next week, for sure, I'll start hitting it. And the only reason why I'm down here, I actually asked them to send me back home because I got a notice in the mail for jury duty like 2 weeks ago before I went home for the holidays, which was like, I went home on the, I want to say the 21st or 20th, I went home. And dispatcher got me home early. Thanks, Robert. And I went home and I got the notice in the mail. I got called by my husband over the phone. He was like, yo, you had jury duty. I was like, oh shit. I was like, I just freaking had jury duty like a year ago. I swear. Like when I first met my husband, I had jury duty. I was like, yo, I wasn't supposed to wait like 7 fucking years for the next jury duty. Apparently not. It's like a year. So I was like, way off. So I'm not happy about that. So I filled out the questionnaire like at the start of my trip, like last week or something like that. I finally got around to doing it. Hopefully I don't get in trouble because I don't even know how many days passed. More than 10 days must have passed between me getting the notice and me actually filling out the questionnaire and everything. It's not a big deal, but I don't know. I don't want to get bitched at when I get there. So I filled out that. That's the reason I'm going home. I would not go home a week after I just came out. That's ridiculous. So when I get there, the plan is to try and get out of it. They ask, you know how they ask the jurors a question? And you're like, do you feel this way about such and such? And they're like, yeah, I do. Let me get the fuck out of here. That's what I'm going to do this week. That's what I'm going to try and do this week. And you know, I'm going to be honest at the time. You know, get out. I don't have time for jury duty this time. I don't. And gives me a little time to go back, see the cat, see my hubby, see my friend, and then head back out of the road because I will not be coming back for like until April. So I'm gonna stay out like 2.5-3 months this time. No, I want 3 months. And it's already like gonna be the freaking middle of January. So I gotta calculate for that. I'm going home. So probably like mid-April, I'll be coming back home. And yeah, you're doing that. I'm gonna miss the cat. It sucks. Longest I've done out is like 2 months. And I was single back then. So I did it. I did it over November and Christmas as well. So 3 months, I'm excited for it to just run hard. But at the same time, I'm like, fuck, dude, 3 months out here, and it's already been a week, and I'm already freaking tired. I'm like, I don't even know how. I was excited when I got back in the truck from freaking, what is it? The holiday. And I was like, yeah, we're getting back in the truck, we're gonna drive. And I'm like, oh god, Jesus, why me? I don't get it. I do kind of get it. I gotta make money. I like my job most days, but it still sucks. Just because I like it doesn't mean I like it. You know what I mean? So. But yeah, just thought I'd hop on here. Oh yeah, what the hell was my point? My point was, like, I'm parked here at the shipper, at the receiver, actually, so, somewhere in Phoenix, and good thing they're not open, and good thing they have some space, so there's, like, no one freaking here, it's, like, dead, so I just parked here. Let's take a look. I just parked here right next to some empty-ass freaking trailer. All right, let me get the shit back. I just saved my hair. I just parked here. I don't think anybody's gonna bother me. So, I got into Phoenix. Oh, yeah, that was what I was gonna talk about. I got into Phoenix, and I was gonna park at the Flying J. It was, like, a couple miles up the road. And awful. I'm like, shoot. So, I do, like, a lap around through the trucks just to see, like, if there are any free spots. The only free spots are some reserved ones. So I'm like, shit, I'm about to leave, go back to the Loves. And I was like, you know what? I'll just take the L today and, you know, pay for parking. I get into the spot. Lovely back, by the way, guys. A1. And security dude looks at me the entire time while I'm backing and then comes up to the side of my truck, and I'm like, oh shit, security dude, he's already busting everybody's chops as soon as I get in here. Ugh. So I'm like, I'm gonna pay. I have just the tiniest bit of attitude, I'm not gonna lie. I fucking hate security guards. If you guys ever dealt with them in the parking, holy shit, you know what I'm talking about. So he was just like, oh, you know, all the reserved is like taken for tonight. And I was like, you fucking serious, dude? All the reserved is taken. And I'm looking on Trucker Path, I'm like, all right, where are the other freaking truck spots? All taken, they're all full. And I believe it because it's Sunday and it's Phoenix. That's just what it is. Sunday, you're gonna have all your truck stops full in the major cities, I'm telling you. It is what it is. Typically, that's how it goes. And most of them are freaking locals, which makes it a kind of, like, stupid. But, whatever. Oh, I got cold out here fast. I was just like, you know what? Search on Google Maps. Let's see if there's any room on the street. I see a couple trailers parked down that way. Nothing parked down that way. But there's plenty of space here, open docks, or open not docks. So I was just like, let me just come to this place. And they're probably not open today. I deliver at 5 a.m., so it works out for me. All I gotta do is, like, wake up at 5 a.m., ask them, hey, yo, or, like, go up to the door or whatever. Hey, yo, where's my doc? And it'll be like, go to doc like 5. And be like, okay, scooch you over, do an offset, and get unloaded, and then go home. That's like all I gotta do. So I love it when I'm grateful, actually. Sometimes, some of the deliveries in Phoenix, you can't do that. And sometimes you get lucky, you're out in the middle of like nowhere, or like in the industrial complex. Typically, you can get away with it. So I was like, yes, thank God, no one's bothering me. And it's like peace and quiet out here. So I enjoy that. Oh, but whenever you can, definitely, any newbies, try and, it's the number one thing you should do. Let's try and find a spot where you're delivering at. Do you just park there overnight and just be ready to go in the morning? Sometimes you don't have to set your clock. Now, tomorrow, I don't care because I'm supposed to be just be going home tomorrow. He's not going to find me a load because apparently he knows that there's nothing going out of Phoenix to Tucson. So, whatever. Oh, I can't complain. But, yeah, so, what the hell was I saying? Park overnight. Park overnight, it makes things a hell of a lot easier. You don't have to start your clock. And free parking. I was gonna pay for parking. I was desperate enough to pay for parking. Well, actually, I wanted a shower. But I guess wanting a shower 2 days in a row is kind of asking for too much out here. So, you know, I gotta suck it up and deal with it. But, whatever. I'll take a shower tomorrow. I sweat it. I changed MVs already, so. Oh. But yeah, guys. I think I'm gonna head out. That's pretty much, I think, all I had to talk about today. I know I'm like kind of like died down from like earlier. I had like so much energy this morning, and now I'm just like, I took my nap and I'm just like chill. Ain't nothing wrong with that though. Had to catch this freaking sun. This light out here is like actually really nice, and the sun's gone down quite a bit since I actually started out here, but it still looks really nice. It still feels nice out here too, like warm-ish. Not my cup of tea. I'd rather have it where it's like blazing hot, burning my skin so I can wear my shorts. But, you know, beggars can't be choosers right now. It's winter. Well, I hope you guys have a good night. And I will see you guys later. Bye.